was going to be an opera singer when I was younger. I trained classically. I thought I was going to be a legit soprano, and that was going to be the path my life took. I was obsessed with going to the opera and seeing everything I could, listening to everything I could. I even went to opera camp. Did you know that was a thing? It's a thing, and I did it. But shortly thereafter, I came to the decision that musical theater was probably a better fit for my personality. But I thought this was so great. I went to college, I went to Carnegie Mellon University, and I thought this is amazing. I'm a classically trained soprano, so I'll be the ingenue in all the musicals, like Laurie in Oklahoma. And I couldn't have been more wrong. You see, I've had much good luck as a performer. I've been cast in almost every show. From Carousel to Hair on Broadway, I was there, but you'd never, ever know. Perhaps you picked me out last year in Phantom, or underneath my dirt in Miserable. But if you tried to pick me out from all the voices in the crowd, I'm certain that you must have had a problem. My plight is quite familiar to those who've tread the boards at the Nederlander, Schubert, or Rialto. And though I've got a great high C, trust me, it's amazing, the reaction seems to be, oh, that's great, dear, but we need you to sing alto. Please give me a chance to sing melody. Just give me a crack at the tune. Chagrin every time I begin by the light of the silvery moon. Just one little shot to sing melody. Just give me a moment to shine. I'm sick of can't help loving that man of mine. Just look at Oklahoma, for example. In the rousing title number of the show, while everyone is singing Oklahoma, from school are we, filled to the brim with girlish glee, pert as a schoolgirl well can be. Three little mates from school. Touch me, it's so easy to leave me. What mirror, where? Which, what, where, who? Sweeney.